Hey there, my name is Drew Brashler, and in this video, I want to talk about feeding the P24 hub using AES50. Now, this can be utilized by both the X32 and the Wing. Now, if you're brand new to my channel, I'm all about helping you feel more confident with your production gear, no matter where you're starting from. Also, if you're looking to learn a little bit more about audio engineering and mixing, I have weekly emails that can come to your inbox, and you can sign up for those for free at audiotoolkit.com. So go check that out. The link is down in the description as well. But let's go ahead and dive in and see how we can get the P24 hub integrated with AES50 with our Behringer Wing. Now, there's two ways of sending our AES50 to our P24 hub. There is the 16-channel version, which will be 33 through 48 if we were wanting to limit the amount of AES50 channels. But in this case, I want to get the most amount of channels sent to my P24 system as I can. So I am going to have my P24 hub set to the AES50 25 through 48. Now, I have my Wing here, and I'm going to go over to routing, and on output group AES50C, this is where I have my routing for my outputs of my console to go into the P24 system. And so on 25 and 26, this would be the first fader on your P24 system as stereo. Now remember, we have the ability of sending stereo to each fader on the P24 system. Now if we were wanting to utilize mono, then we could also send mono channels to this, and we can either choose to sum those two mono channels together between the input 1 and input 2, or in this case 25 and 26, or we can do the dual mode on the unit, and then we can be able to blend between the left and the right of those two inputs. So we have 12 faders, which gives us 24 channels. So those 24 channels would be laid out between 25 and 48. So my 25 and 26 would be my fader 1. My 27 and 28 would be my fader 2, and so on and so forth, following up with 47 and 48 being my fader 12, which where I currently have it set as click. Now, the very last thing that I want to mention is talkback mics. There are two talkback sources on our AES50C that goes to the P24 system. So if we maybe have a front of house talkback and a monitor talkback or a broadcast talkback or maybe a wired MD talkback that's sitting up on stage, we can utilize these two inputs or these two outputs to input into our P24 system. So 23 and 24 would be our two output destinations to get into the talkback volume here. Now, if you weren't wanting to use the talkback system at all, one thing that you could do is you could send your click and your cue down 23 and 24, and then have this just be your click channel, which is a very cool way of getting more out of your P24 system. However, just keep in mind that if any of the users that are using the P24 happen to press and hold the talk button, then that would go over that same line that you have your click and your cue going down. But that would be one way of getting a little bit more flexibility out of the P24 system if you wanted to do that. Now on the output side coming from the P24 system with the hub, we can actually get some sources into our Wing from the P24 hub. So if I go over to my sources and pull up my AES50C where I have my hub connected, we can see that I have my P24 1.1 here. And so if I go and turn up this volume, we can see that I have volume coming in on this first source, and I actually have that routed to a channel so that we can listen to what I'm doing on this P24. So on our routing here, we have our P24 1.1, and then these ones would be 1.2 left and right, meaning that the second P24 in that port 1 would show up on these two channels here. And then on port 2, we have 2.1 for left and right, and then 2.2 for left and right. And then we have P24 3.1, 3.2, 4.1, and 4.2. So you get all of the mix outputs out of the P24 system down the AES50 line that you have connected between your wing or your X32 and your P24 hub. So if you were wanting to then route that signal to, say, a stage box, we definitely could. So I could go to my outputs, and I have a DL32 sitting here on my AES50. And on my outputs 1 and 2, I would want to pull these from my P24 system. So I can go from AES50C, I can go on output 1 to be from that, and then output 2 would be from that. And so at this point, my mix that I'm creating on my first P24 that's on my output 1 off the P24 hub is going now to outputs 1 and 2 on my DL32. So if I was wanting to route that into the in-ear wireless setup that's over in that rack, I definitely can. But don't forget, on the back of the P24, we have 16 mono outs that can be this mixes from the P24 system. So that would give us all 8 of our P24 systems. The very last thing I want to mention is on our output sources from the P24, which would be an input on our console, is that on 47, we have our talkback mics. So if any person uses the talkback function of their P24 system and they press and hold talkback, it's going to come down our C47, or in this case, AES50C47. Or if you have this connected on your AES50A or your B line, it would show up on those as well. So in this case, my talkback is coming in on our AES50C47. And so this is one great way of being able to send this to maybe some near fields for being able to listen to the talkback of that musician. Or if you are just in rehearsal and you don't care about talkback coming through the main PA, you could then pull that into a channel and then turn that up, and you could listen to that in the PA during that rehearsal. Now, this is my favorite way of integrating the P24 ecosystem with the hub into my digital mixer. So obviously this works with the Behringer Wing, but it also works with any other devices that are AES50, X32, M32, so on and so forth. So if you are wanting to integrate your P24 hub with your system, the best way, in my opinion, is using the AES50, because it gives you the most lines and the most returns from the hub to your console. Now, I hope this video is helpful for you today. If you do happen to have any questions, or there's a video that you're hoping that I would make on the P24 or really any of the other production equipment that's out there, please post that in the comment section down below, as I'm always reading through those comments to find videos that are going to be helpful for you. If you haven't already, make sure to check out my website at drewbrashler.com, where I have a bunch of console presets available for the Behringer Wing, the X32, and the X-Air series. Otherwise, I hope you have a great day.